It's a trigger to start rethinking your supply chains, and not always necessarily you end up with a blockchain solution, but the rethinking itself is valuable.
So we're here at the table with Martin van Geels from Fairfood.
Thanks.
Welcome. You were one of the first NGOs as Fairfood to dive into blockchain as a technology.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, we like to look around for possibilities to innovate and to make the food chains more sustainable. And we saw blockchains as a really, really potentially powerful technology. So we just dove into it.
Yeah.
We like to do things first and then look back later.
Yeah.
And we have not
regretted positive.
This.
It was positive, yes.
No, this is good.
Yeah, because I think a large share of the activities of Fairfood are now concerned or focused on blockchain.
Yeah, we have three pillars, if you may say so. We campaign, we do living income research, and we have a blockchain program.
Wow.
Which has now three team members, and we're doing projects, we're building towards a program.
Yeah,
yeah.
Great.
This is the major pillar of Fairfood.
Yeah, yeah. We heard about the coconut blockchain case. We had it in our own meetup here, and I mean, I think you have done a great job in promoting the benefits and the possibilities of having a supply chain on a blockchain supported solution. What happened after? Do we have was Bounty knocking your doors, or what happened?
Well, it's a great thing to be able to walk around with a coconut and start talking about it. I think that's we didn't anticipate that, but that's really a good way to start talking about something that's pretty complicated.
Yeah.
It really opened doors. Indeed, Bounty, Mars, Unilever, Nestle, we're all talking to them. We see that the big players are a little slower. The small ones are ready to go. Where can we get this coconut? People thought we should start selling coconuts, which totally wasn't the intention. But the intention was to knock on some doors and get in, and we did.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's, I hear that from more people. The blockchain is really a trigger of something different, actually.
Yeah, it's a trigger to start rethinking your supply chains, and not always necessarily you end up with a blockchain solution, but the rethinking itself is valuable.
Yeah. Now, I think we will have all our food, at least in the Netherlands or countries like the Netherlands, on blockchain within 5 years. Then Fairfood is obsolete, isn't it? It will sort of outgrow Fairfood.
Well, I can't agree. It would be great. But for Fairfood to be able to quit, these blockchains need to guarantee living wages for farmers.
Yeah.
And you can put the worst situations on a blockchain too. So blockchains itself won't save the farmer. But I think it's a good step in the direction.
Yeah, nice, right. Thank you for learning. Thank you, Fairfood.
No, thanks.